for checking out my channel. If you're new, I am currently a fourth year medical student and I am about to start my residency in emergency medicine. Now that all my classmates have matched into their specialty of choice, I thought now would be a good time to talk about different kinds of doctors. Now there's a ton of different specialties, but I'm going to focus on 10 most common specialties in no particular order. So let's get started. Family medicine. Family medicine is a specialty devoted to the healthcare of people of all ages, so they can take care of the whole family from a child to the elderly. When you're going to your doctor for regular checkups, you're most likely seeing a family medicine doctor. They can do your yearly physical exams, do routine labs, give you vaccinations, and take care of routine healthcare issues like high blood pressure and diabetes. Family medicine doctors have a long-term relationship with their patients, and their residency length is 3 years. Internal medicine. So internal medicine is similar to family medicine, but they generally focus on patients that are 18 years and older. And just like family medicine, the breadth of what you have to know is very wide. One of the main differences between family medicine and internal medicine is that you have access to more fellowships after your residency. An internal medicine residency is 3 years long, and once you're done with your residency, you have the option of pursuing further training called fellowship. And you can go into fellowships in cardiology, hem-onc, gastroenterology, infectious diseases, etc. Pediatrics. Pediatrics is similar to internal medicine, but the main difference is that pediatricians deal with infants, children, and adolescents. You have to know a lot because children's physiology and healthcare needs are different than adults. So in simple terms, you can think of pediatrics as an internal medicine for children. And just like internal medicine, you can further specialize in pediatric cardiology, pediatric hematology oncology, pediatric gastroenterology, etc. Emergency medicine. Emergency medicine is a field that I'm going into, and emergency medicine physicians are responsible for patients that come into the emergency department for whatever reason. We see a lot of different kinds of patients, but our true specialty is in resuscitation and stabilization of very sick patients. In emergency medicine, you see a lot of life-threatening conditions like heart attacks, strokes, or car accidents, but you also see a lot of simple complaints like the flu, lacerations or cuts, and belly pain. Anesthesiology. Anesthesiologists are doctors that are trained to administer anesthesia during surgical procedures. They're responsible for managing and treating critical life functions like breathing, heart rate, and blood pressure while a patient is going through surgery. They also do a lot of procedures like central lines, transesophageal echoes, and epidurals. After a residency in anesthesiology, you can further pursue a fellowship in cardiothoracic anesthesiology, pain medicine, or critical care. OBGYN. OBGYN deals with obstetrics and gynecology. Obstetrics is a field of medicine that deals with pregnancy, childbirth, and postpartum period, and fertility. Gynecology deals with the female reproductive system and can deal with issues like the menstrual cycle, infections, gynecologic cancers, and more. General surgery. General surgery is a medical specialty that uses surgical procedures to treat patients. The surgeries can include things like cancer resections, transplant surgeries, cosmetic surgeries, and open heart surgeries. To give it a little bit of a cultural context, the main characters that you see in Grey's Anatomy are surgical residents who then go on to become attending physicians in different surgical specialties. So speaking of surgical specialties, there are further specializations within surgery that you can pursue after completing a general surgery residency. These include trauma surgery, colorectal surgery, cardiothoracic, etc. There are also surgical specialty residencies that you can go directly into without completing a general surgery residency. And these include orthopedic surgery, plastic surgery, urology, vascular surgery, neurosurgery, and more. Psychiatry. Psychiatrists are doctors that diagnose and treat mental, emotional, and behavioral disorders. Some of the more common conditions treated by psychiatrists include panic disorders, depression and other mood disorders, and schizophrenia. After a residency in psychiatry, you can further specialize in addiction psychiatry, forensic psychiatry, and child and adolescent psychiatry. Diagnostic radiology. Radiologists are doctors that diagnose and treat conditions using a wide variety of techniques like x-rays, CT scans, and MRIs. They use these imaging techniques to diagnose everything from broken bones to serious heart conditions, and they work with doctors in other specialties to give information on how to interpret images from different modalities. Dermatology. Dermatologists are doctors that treat the skin, nails, hair, and the mucous membranes. So that means they treat a wide range of diseases like eczema, acne, psoriasis, skin cancer, and many more. They can also do cosmetic procedures like Botox and laser treatments. There are so many interesting specialties that I didn't mention here, like interventional radiology, PMNR, pathology, ENT, and so many more. If you want to educate other viewers about the specialty that you're interested in, please comment down below. I'd love to read about it. I hope this video was informative and helpful, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.